I've got a BSc honours degree in biology. I did zoology and botany at university, so I've got a really good understanding of New Zealand's ecology. Really, the cat is out of the bag now. Even though government departments and the people that drop these poisons advocate for its use and deny the fact that it's having a devastating impact on not only birds, but also insect life, reptile life, amphibian life. The cat's right out of the bag. There have been several books written about it now, starting in 2009. There's one book in 2009, another one in 2011. Another one has been recently published, this one by Fiona McQueen. She's a medical doctor who's followed the 1080 issue quite closely. The government's got to start listening to other people apart from its own departments. Aerial poisoning should have stopped in 2007 when the Environmental Risk Management Authority, which has now been replaced by the Environmental Protection Authority, had a review of the use of 1080 in New Zealand. That review, theoretically there was public input into that review. In practice it didn't happen. The government departments made an example of a few key scientists, basically pulled all the other scientists into line, and now none of them will speak out. The reason we're dropping poison in New Zealand is political. The claim that the science backs it is completely false. I'll debate that issue with anybody because it's my subject. Yeah, the Parliamentary Commissioner for the Environment, in actual fact, this department is not independent of government. Those claims are just outrageous. The Ministry for Primary Industries, one of their jobs is to protect our farming assets or farming livestock from disease. They have this theory that possums infect cattle with TB. They claim that their science is right, but it's all their own science. It's been reviewed by independent scientists overseas and found to be incorrect. It's very obvious to people like me that have had anything to do with possums and a lot of other New Zealanders that possums don't reinfect cattle. There are scientists in New Zealand. Some of them are starting to speak out now against the wisdom of predator-free. Jamie Steer, who works for the Wellington Regional Council, and there are others like myself that have worked for the government, can see where they're going astray and have decided to get out and get into private industry. The present poison industry in New Zealand has got a lot to do with research funding. I think New Zealand made a mistake in the mid-80s when we started free market science. I think there's definitely a place for pure research in New Zealand. The government should have scientists who are free to study their particular interests outside of universities. The change from Department of Scientific and Industrial Research to the Crown Research Institutes has been a backward step, pulling all the science into just a few bodies. There needs to be several different organisations involved in science and just not one